Good morning, West Henrietta Baptist Church. And good morning to our friends within our local communities and to all our friends on social media. Once again, we welcome you to join us in our worship. Thank God we're alive and well. Those who are sick, we continue to pray for your healing and your restoration, for wholeness for you. And we just ask that God will put a smile on your face this morning as we worship together.
Testament, the book of Psalms, chapter 108, verses 1 through 4. O God, my heart is ready to praise you. I will sing and rejoice before you. Wake up, O harp and lyre. We will meet the dawn with song. I will praise you everywhere around the world in every nation. For your loving kindness is great beyond measure, high as the heavens. Your faithfulness reaches the skies. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Thank you.
The scripture was ably read by Ann Greco. And this morning I want to talk to you on the topic, a heart fixed on God. Or I could ask you a question. What is your heart condition? Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for this beautiful morning. Thank you for your blessings upon us. And thank you for the blessings we will receive in worship today. Your Spirit is with us to lead us and to guide us in all truths. So bless this word this morning, O God. Grant your man servant clarity of mind and purpose. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. The text, Psalm 108, verses 1 to 4. And I'll read the first verse. My heart, O God, is steadfast. I will sing and make music with all my soul. And that's the New International Version. The King James Version reads, my heart, O God, is fixed. I will sing and make music with all my soul. Psalm 57, verse 7. My heart is fixed, O God. My heart is fixed. And Psalm 112, verse 7 reads, he shall not be afraid of evil things. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. Psalm 108 is actually a compilation of sections from two other psalms. You see, Psalm 108, especially verses 1 to 5, is very similar to Psalm 57, verses 7 to 11. And Psalm 108, verses 6 to 13, is almost identical to Psalm 60, verses 5 to 12. You can look up these references for yourself. David begins Psalm 108 by reminding us of the importance of a steadfast or fixed heart in the Christian life. According to the American Heritage Dictionary, the word fixed means firmly in position. It means not subject to change or variation. It means firmly held in the mind. It is a fixed notion. When our hearts are fixed, in the sense of our text, They are established, settled, rooted, and grounded in God. So a fixed heart is one that is settled, grounded, and rooted in God. A heart that is fixed in God is decided, it is set, it is unwavering. In that sense, God desires all our hearts to be fixed on Him. One of the keys to preparing our hearts is to fix our hearts on what we will and what we will not do before we encounter trials and testings and temptations. David had already settled what he would do so that there were no options left when the temptations came. Far too often, Christians have not made strong enough commitments and therefore succumb to temptation. Of course, no one can accomplish preparing their heart on their own. This is not a matter of sheer willpower. God must be involved in preparing our hearts. Psalm 10, verse 17 says, Lord, you have heard the desire of the humble. You will prepare their hearts. So God is the one who prepares our hearts to be fixed on Him. Only when we trust in the Lord and depend on Him can we find the strength to make our hearts not subject to change or variation. Humility is an essential ingredient in the preparation of our hearts. Question this morning, is your heart fixed on God? Hear the psalmist again. Oh God, my heart is steadfast. I will sing and give praise. Oh God, my heart is fixed on you. I will sing and give praise. Let's examine the outworking of a fixed heart in the life of a Christian. The first point I would like to make is that a fixed heart trusts in the Lord for salvation. Trusting God is essential to Christian life. This, however, does not mean that it is easy to trust God, especially in a world that questions the sanity of trusting God at almost every turn. Trusting God is, however, an essential element of true and saving faith that looks to God and finds peace, strength, contentment, and much more in him. And all that God has done, and all that God is doing, and all that God will do, both now and forever in his Son, Jesus Christ. Our hearts need to be fixed in our love to God. Our affections should be definitely set upon things above and not allow sin to have dominion over us. With the fall, mankind placed himself or herself under the dominion of sin. This means sin took authority over us. It drove our lives and our decisions and control our choices and our action and left us unable to resist it from the beginning of time. Therefore, we cannot allow sin to have dominion over us. And we cannot blame the devil because sinning is our choice. It is our choice to sin. Get this. Salvation is God's solution to the dominion of sin over us. And somebody praise God for that. Salvation is God's perfect provision to release us from the dominion of sin, which is sustained by our choice. Salvation is the good news of Jesus. Jesus the Christ. Salvation is delivered to us in gifts of God's grace, in gifts of God's mercy, in gifts of God's forgiveness, and in gifts of eternal life. A heart fixed, trust in the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation. Jesus died for us on the cross. If we have trusted him, we have fixed our heart upon him, and we have experienced his mercy. The psalmist sings, "For your mercy is great above the heavens, and your truth reaches to the clouds." Verse 4 of our text. Question this morning, is your heart fixed on Jesus? What is your heart's condition this morning? Let me move to the second point. It is a heart that is fixed on Jesus is devoted to Jesus. A heart that is fixed on God is devoted to God. And in Psalm 57, verse 7, we have, "My heart is fixed," repeated twice. And what it does is that it adds emphasis to the expression of unalterable determination. His determination will not be altered by circumstances. His heart remains on Jesus. His heart remains on God. His heart is fixed. His mind made up. It's Here's somebody who has a testimony this morning. You see, the fixed heart is resolved to sing and to give praise to God in spite of everything that might make sobs and tears that may choke the song. But you'll sing anyhow. My heart is fixed. My mind is made up. My heart is fixed on God. Unalterably fixed. You see, when the psalmist says my heart is fixed, he does not merely mean that he is conscious of a steadfast love, but also fixed and settled. It's a fixed and a settled determination. And he speaks of an abiding communion, a thought between himself and God. There is nothing but sin that is incompatible with a fixed heart. Sin is incompatible with the resolved will. And it's incompatible with continual communion with God. The psalmist's heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. That is the secret of a fixed heart. It's the secret of a heart that is dedicated to God. This fixity is continuous. It's rooted and grounded in God. This fluttering, changeful, unreliable, emotional nature of ours will be made calm and steadfast only by faith in God. To set you right, to set your heart at the right place with God. How can we measure our devotion to God in Jesus Christ? I suggest that if you are truly devoted to God in Jesus Christ, you will love God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. If your mind is fixed on God, you will love your neighbors, you will love one another. If your mind is fixed on God, you will have a healthy and growing relationship with God. Then worship for you is not a duty. It's a joy. It's a pleasure. Prayer is not a chore. It is cultivated through closeness of your walk with God. You will have a desire to listen and hear God as he calls you into purposeful living. And you will desire that God will empower you and that God will maximize your potential to be a warrior for him. Is your heart fixed on God? My final point is that a fixed heart on God is hopeful. I have to be honest with you. For many, these days are bleak. The coronavirus has fundamentally changed the way our society works. And even more depressing, there are some serious ways in which the family has to reckon with life. But the psalmist, his steadfast confidence in God gave him a fixed point from which he could and would sing and give praise. He was always praising God because he was hopeful. My challenge to you this morning, get your heart fixed on God. Get your confidence in God established, your trust in him unwavering, in such a way that his love, his faithfulness, his kindness, and his fatherhood will become too real for us to doubt his promise. Are you hopeful this morning? You need not be afraid to trust God. Scripture says, heaven and earth shall pass away, but God's word shall never pass away. His promises are as solid rock beneath your feet. Let your confidence run to God until you can shout, my heart is fixed, my mind made up. I will trust in the living God. I'm also arguing this morning that our hearts need to be fixed in purpose. You see, it is not enough to believe in God and to believe in his truth. The devil believes that. Satan believes that. We may believe in many things and yet be wavering, yet being tossed to and fro, uncertain and unsatisfied with God. To get out of this condition, we must adopt a fixed purpose of adjusting ourselves to the truth, to obeying God, and to living for him every day. Some people look forward to the future with uncertainty. They are never certain as to how they are going to do tomorrow. But there is a song, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fears are gone. I know I can face tomorrow. Because he lives. Are you doubtful this morning? You see, the uncertainty is based on a lack of fixed purpose. The uncertain is based on lack of faith in God. You see, our hearts need to be fixed in faith. You see, we live in an age of many, many faiths. We live in an age with many gods. And there are multiple voices saying, look there, look here, look over there. And if our hearts are to be fixed in this age, when there are so many fads and doctrines, then it is urgent that we get settled firmly in the truth. The truth is that there is hope. no matter what you have been through. There's hope no matter what you're going through. Be hopeful then about the power and the effects of your prayer. If you're hopeful, you'll pray hopeful prayers. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but only lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock, I stand all of the ground. Is sinking sand. All of the ground is sinking sand. Trust. Be hopeful. Is your heart fixed on God? You see, you can have peace in your heart when your mind is fixed on God. So let me leave this challenge with you. A fixed heart is a choice that you have to make. It is choosing to place God above all fears and all evil tidings. Do you sometimes feel so burdened down? And you cannot keep your mind stayed on God? Isaiah 26:3, God will keep them in perfect peace, whose minds are stayed on Him, because they trusted in Him. Wonderful promise. And David gives us his secret as to how he keeps his mind stayed on God when he's going through a rough time. Jesus says in John 14:1, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. See, the cure for the troubled heart is to fix it upon God. Fix it upon Jesus. You see, when our heart is fixed, it is established, it is settled, it is rooted and grounded in God. It is set, it is unwavering. The condition of a person's heart reveals much about the condition of that person's soul. A fixed heart is in tune with Jesus. A fixed heart finds peace in Jesus and with Jesus. A fixed heart is trusting, devoted, serving, and hopeful. I challenge you that the biggest barrier to surrendering your life to Jesus is the world. All that is worldly. All that becomes an obstacle to you having your heart fixed on Jesus. The things that attract, the things that occupy your mind, the pleasures of the world, the fleeting things, the things that lead to hell, the things that rob you of your peace with God. That which attracts you and envelops you and make you a slave. All that looks exciting, but it's temporary. Songwriter says, turn your eyes up on Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and peace. Is your mind fixed on God? Do you want your mind to be fixed on God? Is this a desire of yours? Let us pray. Almighty God, thank you for the word. And thank you for all those who have listened. Whatever they are going through this morning, I pray, God, that they may turn their eyes to you, look to you, change their life so that their hearts may be fixed on you. Lord, I lift up those who are sick this morning. May they understand that you are the ever-present God. You are an ever-present help in time of trouble. And your name is like a fortified tower in which we find safety and security. Remind us, Lord, that you're always with us. You will never leave nor forsake us. You are a rock of ages. You are our God forever and ever. Amen.
Yeah.
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.